Hey everybody, welcome back. My name is Nicole. If you're new to the channel, welcome. There's a subscribe button down below. Make sure to click it so you can find out every time I post a new video. If you're new to my channel, welcome. Subscribe, like the video, comment down below. Today's video, we are going to be talking about the new Power Rangers movie. Not really gonna get into much detail about it. I don't want to spoil it. These are gonna be one of those spoiler free reviews, more or less. I will be talking about some things. There will be a few things here and there that I mentioned about the movies, but I'm not gonna go into total talk about it. But let's get right into it.
None of us really know each other, but we were all in the same place when Billy found those coins.
What is that? Aren't you so weird?
We're strong.
Saying be strong.
The answer to what is happening to you is here. You five are the Power Rangers. Any other questions?
Are we more like Iron Man or Spider-Man?
Could you just say something? Anything.
Me and four kids found a spaceship buried underground.
Whoa!
Pretty sure I'm a superhero.
What?
Guys?
Five little rangers.
How cute.
Let's go!
Yeah! Power Rangers!
Yeah!
Power Rangers.
None of us really know each other.
We're all screw-ups.
But somehow, we were all in the same place at the same time when Billy found those coins.
Guys! Check out how we glow.
I'm blue.
No, I'm black.
What?
I am.
No, you're not.
No.
Don't you feel weird?
We're strong.
Insanely strong.
The answer to what is happening to you is here. You five are the Power Rangers.
Did I just hear you say we're Power Rangers?
Is this some kind of joke? We're talking to a wall.
I was kind of expecting a little more.
So where were you last night?
Me and four kids found a spaceship buried underground. I'm pretty sure I'm a superhero.
Cool. Pee in that cup.
Power Rangers were a legion of warriors. You must become those warriors.
It's just a hologram, like a video game.
That's a strong-ass hologram.
Not a video game. No one man should
have all that power. You were born for this.
I will destroy everything.
She is pure evil.
How do you expect us to stop her?
It's morphin' time.
Do it better than anybody you ever seen do it.
It's a lot of gold.
This is your destiny.
Let's go! Go!
This is your time.
So I have made a list of things that I remembered after seeing it right off the back of the movie when I got home. First thing is first, the movie is about 2 hours long. I was very excited for this movie. I did grow up with the Power Rangers TV show in the 1990s. Now, I wasn't hardcore Power Rangers, but I did watch the show here and there. When I left the movie, I felt like there was something missing. I did speak to a different other people. I've seen a couple of reviews and a lot of people have said the same thing. Like, it just, it's a bleh. It wasn't like a high action. There was way too much hype about it. More than what needed to be given. This wasn't something that was like out of this world, like, oh my God type of movie. Let's see. It was an amazing movie, but like I said, it was 2 hours. The first half an hour, 45 minutes, they did the development of the characters, like introducing the five teenagers that were going to become the Power Rangers, and developing the world and the original, like Zordon, and he was the original Ranger, and then Rita was part of the Power Rangers and she turned evil, and like that whole world building was like the first 45 minutes, and developing the new characters, Billy, Jason, Zach, Trini, and Kimberly. So they developed their characters, and like Kimberly was the cheerleader that got kicked out of cheerleading, Jason the football player that got in trouble and was under house arrest, and etc, etc. Now, I did like the fact that they made Trini, which is the Yellow Ranger, part of the LGBTQ community. There was a joke in the movie where Zach, which plays the Black Ranger, said like, oh, do you have boyfriend troubles? And she's like, yeah, something like that. And he was like, oh, girlfriend troubles. So she is a lesbian in the movie. I did like that. Right off the bat, when I heard that she was going to be part of that, I was very excited about that part. And the other one was Billy, which is the Blue Ranger. He has a type of autism, which also, they don't say it right off the bat, but you can tell with certain things that he does, where he has to have the color pencils specifically, and he just like, there's his mannerisms, you can tell he has a sort of type of autism, and that's another thing that they're bringing out into the world, where it's being more inclusive of different types. And then a lot of people were like, oh, well, we need more Asian-y characters, especially with the whole live action Mulan thing going on, where they don't want the songs from the Mulan movie, then whatever, that's a whole different Disney thing. But the Black Ranger Zach is an Asian actor, so like they're bringing more diversity into the actors, which I'm totally for. Let's see what else I have here. They did say after the release this past weekend that this franchise is going to be 7 movies, so this was one, so there's 6 more to come. I'm not sure if they're going to keep the same 5 to keep on going. I think they might do it for the next one, because how they left the movie at the end was a cliffhanger. The 5 of them are basically in detention, so it's like a Breakfast Club type of thing. And then that's another thing, the ending credits, or the ending scene credit, shows a green jacket and the detention team going Tommy is the green/white ranger. So the next movie they're bringing in the Green Ranger, I take that as, and then the original 5 rangers are just there in detention throwing paper with like ninja skills around. So let's see, Elizabeth Banks, who plays Rita, is very creepy. I know Rita is like this over-the-top type of character in the TV show, but in the movie she was very creepy, at least in the beginning, like when they first found her and like she was trying to get her energy back and all that. Once she put on her green suit with her staff, she was more okay, but she was very creepy. I don't do good with scary movies and stuff like that, so I was kind of freaked out a bit, but she did a good job. What else do I have here? The suits. So originally when I saw pictures of them, and like, you know how the movie theaters have those cut lifeboard cutouts of them, was not thrilled about the suits, but in the movie it came out good. It gave me more of an Iron Man suit type of feel thing. The girl suits, the red and pink, red, look at me, the pink and yellow Power Ranger suits in the TV show, they were like a silk type of fabric when the girls had skirts over their leggings. Here in the movie, they have the Iron Man suit, but they had breastplates, so you can actually tell that, hey, they're girls type of thing. So I kind of liked it. The suits have grown on me, so I'm okay with that. I am jumping around, but like I said, like the first 45 minutes were it was building the world and the characters. Then they spent a good hour, more or less, of the movie training and getting to know each other, and like it was just like a slow, chill movie, and it's like, okay, it all goes together. I think like one of the reviews that I saw, that the guy had said he felt like he saw 2 different movies. So like the first one was chill, like okay, and then the last half an hour, 45 minutes of the movie is where all the action is. So he there was like, that's like the second movie. I kind of agree with that, like the first half of the movie, the first majority part of the movie, where they're training and stuff like that, that's okay, it's cool. A lot of cool visual effects and stuff like that. The ending, the fight scene, they hadn't even finished training. They had just learned how to morph into their suits. And now they're in this big battlefield battling the monster of gold and these rock monsters and all this other stuff. And now, out of nowhere, they know how to drive the dino cars. Like, they barely know how to fight. How do they automatically know how to drive their machine, their cars? Like, that's something that was like a little loophole there. Like, there's nothing that explains it. There's even one part in the movie where Billy says, oh, I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know what button to press. So obviously they don't know exactly what they're doing, but they're doing it. And the Pink Ranger's flying her pterodactyl or whatever bird it was car. So there was a funny line when Rita says, oh, the Power Rangers found their costumes and their dino cars. That was funny. I laughed very hard at that line. There was another joke that I was like, oh, okay, haha, funny. They made references to Transformers. There was a part where one of the Rangers had grabbed a yellow Mustang with a black stripe down it and threw it against one of the monsters or Rita's minions, whatever you want to call them. And he goes, oh, sorry, Bumblebee. So that was funny. That was a Transformers reference. But yeah, I'm looking over my list of things that I wanted to talk about. That's pretty much it. Yeah, so if you guys have any questions or any comments about the movies, did you guys see the movie? Comment down below. Let's have a discussion about it. As always, you can tweet me, follow me on Instagram, Twitter. I also have a Facebook page that I'm revamping to match with the new rebrand of my channel. So I'm working on that. But until next time, bye guys.